and welcome to the Mike Less Farmhand Mike YouTube channel, bringing you some of the biggest and best variety and definitely the most versatile farming content on social media today. You can find me on YouTube, Instagram, TikTok, and Facebook at Farmhand Mike. Hey everyone, welcome back for another wheat harvest video. In this video, I am out in a wheat field northwest of Tribune, Kansas, and I am out here with Paplow Harvesting, who is a custom harvesting crew based out of Minnesota. They make the wheat run every year, starting wheat harvest in Texas, and as the wheat crop ripens, they work their way north, cutting wheat all the way up into Montana and North Dakota. Then they turn around and do fall crops in various other states. I've done some wheat harvest videos with these guys in years past that you can find on my YouTube channel. I met these guys down in Texas where they do kick off the wheat harvest, Oklahoma and South Central Kansas. Now I did film this on July 16th, and normally in this area wheat harvest is wrapped up. They've had quite a year here. Last fall when this winter wheat was seeded, it was very dry. Some of the crop did not emerge the way it was supposed to. And then when it was time for harvest, they started getting a lot of rain. That's what's delaying the harvest right now. Of course, when they start getting a lot of moisture late like that, the weeds start coming up, and you're gonna see some of that in this video. To start the video off here, they come out to the field. They had all the combines lined up, as you've seen a little bit ago, serviced everything, fueled it up. They are moving five of their combines right now to start another wheat field, and then they have four other combines, another tractor and grain cart that is working a few miles away. And later on in the video, they will have all nine of their Case International 8250 combines with 45-foot MacDon Draper heads running in the same field. One of the combines did have a 50-foot Draper head on it. Also running in the field, they are running three Case International Magnum tractors, two 340s pulling Brent 1396 grain carts, and then their Case International 380 tractor is pulling an Elmers 1300 Haulmaster grain cart. And if I had to guess, I'd say a lot of people watching this video have no idea where Tribune, Kansas is. It's not very far from the Colorado state line. It's west central Kansas here. Tribune, Kansas was founded in 1886, and as of 2020 has a population of 772 people. Tribune, Kansas sets at about 3,616 feet elevation, and this area averages just under 18 inches of rain per year. While they were moving fields, this versatile 450 tractor was parked at an intersection out here on the dirt roads. I don't know what the story is. I was just told this tractor's been sitting here for a lot of years. Now, this has to be an early 450 because I see it does have the synchro transmission in it. I don't think there was a lot of those built. Anyway, someone watching this has to know what the deal is. Just curious, and I did go on to satellite image, and I even found it right there. So, again, if somebody has some information, share it in the comment section. I'm sure we would all like to know. That's going to do it for this video. Thank you very much for watching. Feel free to go down there and hit that like button, leave a comment. And if you're new to my channel, I would really appreciate it if you go down there and hit that subscribe button. And of course, check back often. I still have a ton of footage from years past in the archives to get edited up here on my YouTube channel. And if you want to see more of what I'm doing, you can also follow me along on Instagram, Facebook, and TikTok at Farmhand Mike. Again, thank you for watching, and we will see you on the next video.